Now, President Trump, who's recently promised to push for tightening background checks on potential gun buyers, has also said he supports arming certain teachers and other faculty inside schools.
Now, back here at home, Shelby County Mayor Mark Luttrell has announced the creation of a new school safety task force following the shooting in Florida. Mayor Luttrell joins us this morning here on Live at 9.
Good morning.
Always glad to have you back here.
Thank you all.
You have been quoted as saying this is a critical and an urgent matter for our community as well. Why so?
Well, certainly, I think it goes without saying that school security has got to be our number one priority. If we're going to be progressive in education, then it starts with putting our children in a learning environment and reassuring parents that their children are safe. So I think our top priority before we can do anything else in education is to ensure the security and safety of our children.
So I'm going to assume that your first meeting last week was mainly assessing what we do now. Were there any gaps identified?
Well, yes, there were some gaps that were identified. There was certainly the assessment that you speak of, but what was most important is that we were able to get so many different players from different areas at the table. We were the U.S. attorney, the state's attorney, mm-hmm. law enforcement mm-hmm. entities, school officials, government officials, to sit down and say, okay, we've got a problem. We don't have the answers, but we've got to do something mm-hmm. in response to the public. Yes, and we started looking at, you know, what are the things that we know need to be addressed. What can we do now, or what are we doing now? But our focus going forward is really going to be twofold. Number one, what must be done today mm-hmm. to ensure safety today? And then systemically, what can we do that plans for the future? So it's going to be daunting from the standpoint of finding some quick answers that must be done now, and then also trying to take the long view of what can be done over the years to come.
One of the issues you also talked about and was discussed was threat assessment
yes.
and readiness.
Mm-hmm.
What yep. can be done there to improve that?
Well, we have a system in place now for threat assessments. We just need to make sure that it's being used. But our Office of Emergency Management has an ongoing threat assessment program that we use throughout the community, not just in schools, but in our faith community. Of course, our churches are vulnerable as well in neighborhoods. But we're going to be focusing on everything on threat assessment to people on the street and in the community being very sensitive to some of the issues around them, that parents get involved with their schools in a more aggressive way, that we have some enhanced training for both students and staff within the schools, and then of course looking at, to the extent that we can, harden security within our school facilities. So there's everything from physical security to what we would call intelligence security, intel security, all of those things that go into play in building a secure environment.
And what's your stance? We've heard, especially over the past week or so, President Trump somewhat suggest that teachers should be armed as well. Are we to that point? Is that something, Mayor, you would support?
I don't think we're at that point now, and I'm certainly not an advocate for that at this point. I think teachers are trained to teach. And we've got to see what we can do short of that, of arming our teachers. Let's focus on what we can do to get our teachers doing what teachers are really trained to do, and let's look at the other security features that must be enhanced. I'm sure guns will be a subject of discussion, which they should be. Where we're going to go with that, I just don't know at this point. We do have a lot of different opinions at the table, and we'll just have to kind of, you know, put them out there on the table and see what the support is and what we can do. We do know that there are things that must be done immediately, and that's what we're going to focus on this week and going forward for the short term.
And can you be a bit more specific about that? Because you mentioned there were some gaps identified.
Well, certainly. I think the assessment is something that we can do immediately, is make sure that those buildings and those facilities that we know are vulnerable, that they have a good threat assessment. And that threat assessment is going to tell us everything from, do we have too many entrances to school facilities?
Gotcha.
Are they hardened? Do we have good security within the school system? Do you have good coordination between school security and law enforcement? Those are the things, the gaps that we need to focus on now. I think we probably need more security officers within our schools, mm-hmm. referred to as the school resource officers.
But I guess the question there is, Mayor, can we afford that?
Well, everything has a price tag to it,
yeah.
and certainly that would have a price tag. What we're talking about is going to cost money, but I can't think of a higher priority. for spending money. And having been a school teacher myself at one time and knowing the vulnerabilities and the gaps and knowing how our culture has changed is just something that we can't neglect.
All right. So you're meeting, you're going to try to meet again this week,
right? We're
going to
be meeting this week. In fact, my office will be is working this morning. We talked on Friday about where and when. So my office this morning is working to touch base with all 10 of the players from this past week. There, some folks have reached out to me wanting to be included in the discussion. And I think that we'll consider expanding the size of our group as well.
Awesome. Right. So we'd love to have you back.
Yeah, keep us up to date.
Well, I'd love to. And I appreciate you all putting some focus on this, because this is an area where we really need to keep the public informed about what can be done outside the school system by our parents and certainly the various other constituencies across Shelby County.
All right. Absolutely. Thank you for your time.
Thank you all.